to be released in our midst. May the word of God be implanted in our spirits like the incorruptible seed. May it bear fruit that will bring change and transformation to many lives, families, and even different circumstances that are represented here. Use me today as a vessel of honor for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated in the name of Jesus. And I'm so happy that we have visitors in the house of the Lord today. After the service, we will be welcoming you officially and getting to know you. Otherwise, just feel in the presence of God as we continue with the sermon series, The Heritage of Faith. We have a heritage in Christ, and one of it is faith. In this church, we have five core values. Our first core value is prayer. Okay. Is my interpreter's microphone on? Testing. Okay. You're on?
Yes.
Okay. Our first core value in this church is prayer. Secondly, we value the word. We value integrity. And thirdly, that's what I'm teaching, we value faith. And fifthly, we value integrity. Excellent. So prayer, word, integrity, faith, and excellence. Five things that describe us as Femites in Kutus. I'm taking some time to teach about faith because I know I am speaking to righteous men and women. If you are a righteous person, say, I am. And the Bible says that the righteous shall live by faith. We live by faith. And by the way, living by faith does not mean laziness. In that now somebody doesn't work, and if you ask them what do you do for a living, they say I live by faith. No. Living by faith does not mean not working. But living by faith is constant and total reliance on God in everything you do. So anything we do it by faith. Our trust is not in our pocketbook. Our trust is not even in our checkbooks. Because we know banks collapse. And our monies which are there, they cease becoming our money. But our God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He never goes on liquidation. He is never absent. To anyone who has faith, God will become their reward. That is why we live by faith. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, trust in God with all your heart.
Trust in God with all your heart.
Okay, let me start with a true story of a certain place that there is a very great valley or a canyon. So between two rocks, and there is an acrobat that has specialized on walking on a tight rope. So he ties a rope on one side of the rock to the other side of the rock, and the depth of the canyon is very, very deep. If anybody fell there, straight away they would die. And because this acrobat has practiced walking on ropes, You see low levels. He took his stand into that high level. And people gather to see him and cheer him. Walking from one side to the other side. And if it's your first time to see him, you'd of course be afraid for his life. Because if he falls, he doesn't have any headgear, he doesn't have any rope. Should he fall, the rope would sustain him. So you would be afraid. You are about to see a success stunt, or you'll just see somebody die. So people, they look at him, they're holding their breath, and there he walks on the rope. At times it's like he will fall down. People are praying for him. Others, they are gasping, they are holding at their mouth, holding their breath, and he keeps walking until to the other side, and everybody claps. And some who've seen them, who've seen him, they say, "I knew he would do that. I knew he would do that." And then he would ask the people, "Would you want me to go again to the other side?" And they would want to see a second time. And again he walks on the rope. He's walking again. And he gets to the second side. And people clap. Then now he says, "I will do it differently." And he takes a wheelbarrow, puts stones or anything in a load, and he says, "I'm going to walk on the rope with it." And now everybody wonders, will he make it? It was easier for him to walk alone. But now going with a wheelbarrow, and they look, and sure enough, he walks on the rope on top of the canyon with his wheelbarrow. And when you think he would fall, he balances himself to the second side. Even you would clap, and you would say, "This is a professional, this is a star." And then he asked, "Would you want me to do it again?" And he does it. So after doing it severally, he asks people, "Do you think I can go from one side of this canyon to the other using by myself?" Because you've seen it, you will say yes. And then he asks, "Do you believe I can do it with a wheelbarrow?" Because you've seen it, then you believe it, you straight away say, "Yes, you can." Then he throws a challenge. "Okay, now I'm going to go to this side. I'm going to walk the rope again with the wheelbarrow. But I want to carry you, Mr. Mushiri, into that wheelbarrow. So come and sit on the wheelbarrow so that I can drive you over the rope to the other side of the car." What do you think Mr. Mushiri will say? Tell your neighbor, "How great is God?" So why is it difficult, yet you've seen him walking and even driving the wheelbarrow from one side to the other? The answer lies in one word. Trust. Trust. So it is like, we believe God is able to do or to walk from here to there. But when God tells us, "Let me carry you on this wheelbarrow," it's like, yes. For us to have faith, we need to absolutely trust in the Lord. And that is our scriptural reference, foundational scripture for this series. Isaiah 51, verse 1 and 2, we are told to look at Abraham and Sarah, our father and mother. And the Bible told us, God called Abraham But when Abraham obeyed, he blessed him and he increased him. Therefore shall it be for you. By faith, when God calls you and you answer and obey, indeed God will bless you. And indeed God will increase you. In the name of Jesus. I am here to declare and to tell you, when you walk by faith, when you trust in the Lord 100%, He will bless you like Abraham, and He will increase you also. In the name of Jesus. So we continue with the scripture that we read this morning. After what we had read last Sunday, from Galatians chapter 3 verse 29. Now that we are born again, there is a baptism we need. It's not just the baptism of water, not just to be baptized into His body, but we need to be baptized into Christ. Okay, Galatians chapter 3 verse 26, 27, and 29. Okay, let's read together. I want to go. For you are all sons of God through faith in Christ. So when you have faith in Christ Jesus, total dependence on Christ Jesus, total reliance on Christ Jesus, you become a child of God, a son of God. Because for us, let's read together, for as many as are, but okay, let's read together, for as many of you as were baptized into Christ, you have put on Christ. After being born again, there is a baptism we need. A baptism into Christ. Into Jesus, the anointed one. The anointing that was upon him. So that we will now be clothed with Christ. This is where we become different. Where Paul teaches us that we are in him, or in whom, or by him, or by whom. When we start in that place called Christ, we are different people. We are able to do what Jesus Christ was able to do. In the name of Jesus. So verse number 29 tells us, if then you are Christ, then who are you? You are Abraham's seed. And what are you also? Hallelujah. You are an heir according to the promise. If you are Christ, then you are Abraham's seed. And an heir according to the promise. So Abraham's seed is made up of the DNA of Abraham. It's made up of the genealogy of Abraham. And in our subject, it is the issue of faith. Somebody make a confession and say, I am a man or a woman of faith. Anything you will receive from God, you will receive it because you have faith. Alright, let me tell you this. Christ is like a storehouse. He is like a bank that God has provided for you. Anything you need now, and anything you will need even in the future, God put it in Christ. It is in Christ. So there is nothing that you are believing God for today. There is nothing you are praying God for today that God has not already given you. And He has given you in Christ. It is in Christ.
Ephesians 1:3
proves it.
Blessed be God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
who has blessed us.
Past tense. Not that he is blessing us, not that he will bless us, but he has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. So in Christ, everything you are believing God for is provided. But now I teach you, your access to this blessing needs faith. Faith is like a hand that reaches out into this storehouse and picks and receives whatever you are believing God for. So when you do not have faith, whatever you need is given, but you cannot receive it. Are we together? When you don't have faith, or when your faith is not enough to receive, whatever you are believing God for is already given. It is there, but you cannot reach it. I learned that in 1994. I was attending a conference of a prophet of God called Morrison
Lowe
in Pangani Secondary School grounds. And I went there believing God for a miracle. And one of the afternoon, he conducted a miracle rally. I was among the school suits in front because I came to that service at 5 a.m. And I remember when he called for people who need miracles, I was very near the podium. And as he was praying, what I was believing God for, my spiritual eyes were open. And I saw it was above me. I really saw it. Can you imagine? Let's say you are believing God for a car. You come to the altar. And while you close your eyes, believing God for the car, all of a sudden you are seeing a vision, and your car is just above your head. I was excited, and they said my miracle has come. But in my vision, I saw myself having a small hand. A small hand. And I was trying to reach out to the miracle. I could not touch it. I was trying to jump. I could not reach it. I kept trying. Until I was tired, and I was tired, and all I could do was just look at it. Meanwhile, the prophet is prophesying. He's praying for people. A pastor friend of mine called George Mulingen, he was amongst the people who were healed of stomach ulcers, and he testified on the altar. Now here I am. I have seen my miracle, but I did not receive it. That's when I learned. Faith is a hand. Faith is a hand. A small boy has a small hand. A grown up man has a bigger hand. So if my faith grew, I can reach out to anything I want. That's why I'm teaching you faith. Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. I declare to you in the name of Jesus, you will become such a giant of faith. You will have such a big hand of faith. Whatever you pray for, it will not take time. It will come in the name of Jesus very quickly to you. Because people say, Pastor, I've been praying for this thing.
Pastor, And I have been praying for this issue. Why has it not been answered? Maybe.
No.
This would be the answer.
No,
little faith. Jesus told the disciples, oh, ye of little faith. The little faith is becoming big faith. In the name of Jesus. And it shall quickly receive what God has already given. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I told you, the building we are about to dedicate is an example of what faith can do. When you believe and when you speak and you go ahead and act, your faith is able to produce a lot. I have told you about Sister Carol. In 2013, she called me and told me,
Pastor.
And she reminded me the other day, it's not 7,000, she sent me
5,000.
She sent me 5,000. And she told me, with this 5,000, see how you can renovate the peak latrines that are near the office. As we believe God for 300,000. So that we can make wonderful washrooms in Femkutu. And in 2013, I remember, I told myself, 300,000. Where will we get 300,000 from? And I did not have faith for 300,000 in 2013. Thanks be to God. There is a beginning of the year, but there is also the end of the year. When we came to 2014, and I went to our current church, and it was a faith walk and journey, and I kept seeing what they had done. My faith grew when I saw the facility center there. I remember I told Minister Charles, let me pray. And I touched the wall. And I said, Father, you are a God who is not a respecter of persons. You are the same everywhere. If you have done this year in time, I believe you. You shall do the same for us in Kudus. In the name of the Lord Jesus. And today is the reality. In the name of Jesus. Today, we have auditors that are auditing the accounts of that building and the others. And that building is worth 12 million shillings debt free. May you grow to be used to hundreds of thousands. May you grow to become used to millions. Because by faith, all things are possible. I say by faith, all things are possible. Eight dimensions of faith. Yes. Eight descriptions of what faith is. That's what I want to teach. Understanding faith. Number one, faith is a spiritual force. Yes, faith is a spiritual force. When somebody is operating in faith, they have a spiritual force they are working with. Physics teaches us that force is a push or a pull acting on an object as a result of interaction with another object. Now, you live in two worlds. You live in this natural world that you are called just as Kimotho. And
natural person. But now that you have been born again, your spirit is alive. The word of God in your spirit produces a spiritual force called faith. A spiritual force called faith. This faith makes you operate in another world called the spirit world, the spiritual realm. Now listen. The Bible says you do not walk by sight on this physical earth, but you who is born again, you walk in the spirit realm and you walk by faith. Amen. You are alive in the spirit world should and will dominate and determine the life you live here on earth. In the name of Jesus. So just like in physics, when an object interacts with another object, there is a push or there is a pull. Likewise, when you are in faith, your faith as a force will push things in the physical world, or it can even pull things in this physical world. Let me tell you, where was your to him? In faith and by faith, you will do amazing things. Physics teaches us there are different types of forces at work here on earth through science. There is gravitational force. So the earth has a force of itself that anything that leaves earth, the force of gravity wants to pull it back to the earth. A balloon going up, the force of gravity wants to bring it down. If you throw a ball up, the force of gravity brings it down. You never see the force of gravity, but you can see the result of the force of gravity. So is your faith. Physics teaches us there is magnetic force. Yes, a very innocent piece of metal that has magnetic force. When when there is a positive and a negative, it will attract something towards itself. It's a force that is at work. So it is also in faith. When you have faith, you have a force at work in your life or through your words that will pull and attract things. Physics teaches us there is a force that is tensional. Yes, tensional force. That even a piece of wire can suspend a whole container like we have here, that is more than one pound in weight. I'll never forget when they were hoisting those containers. And this gentleman, he tied to the corners of the container a rope that seemed like it cannot hold the container up. I could not trust it. Tunainuaga container ene imejaa mizigo na hii kamba. And sure enough, when the crane lifted up the container, more than 1,000 kilograms was hanging at a rope that I had despised. It
because of tension of force.
There is an ability in that rope or that small wire
to
hold so much weight. Let me tell you, brother and sister, do not despise a man or a woman who has faith. Did you hear what I say? Or a woman who has faith. Their faith is like that physical, is like that rope that has tension of force, even if it doesn't look like. Therefore, today, they may not look the part. Don't despise them. Tomorrow, their faith will bring them to a place. Utamuangalia ushangae. When you're making a confession of faith, unaambia watu vile gari yako itakuwa. Unawaambia hii kifungo ya gari yako iko kwa mfuko. Watu wanakudespise sababu ya vile wanakujua. Wanajua ulisomea wapi. Wanajua unaishi wapi. Lakini chenye hawajui ni imani iliyo ndani yako. Hiyo imani kesho itakufikisha mahali ambapo Mungu amekupangia. Haya. Utapita hivi. Mungu aliingie maido.
Ni
yeye ama si yeye? Blessed are they that believe without seeing. Hallelujah. Faith is a spiritual force. Let us learn how to use this spiritual force. Faith is released, or the force of this, the force of this faith is released when we speak faith-filled words. When we speak faith-filled words, we release this force that can push or can pull. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said,
Jesus,
if you believe, so in other words, if you have faith, even if it's as small as a mustard seed, tell this mountain, that is something impossible. Can you imagine? Waking up one morning and we don't have from Kenya. You can see
the
Nyuki. You can see
Narumoru.
Because there is no longer a mountain. That is a dream. That is an impossibility. In our physical world. But Jesus said, when we have faith, even if it is small as a mustard seed, we can tell a mountain to be uprooted and be cast to the sea. In other words, we can tell impossible situations and they become possible. Hello? In God's vocabulary, there is no word impossible. Oxford Dictionary has a word impossible. So is Webster. And Longman and all the others. But Heaven's Dictionary, if you look for the word impossible,
impossible.
With God, all things are possible. I think with God, all things. With God, all things are
possible.
That is why
Sarah,
she laughs when she is told, such a time next year, you'll have a child. Sarah in the natural realm. She is looking at her birth certificate. Next year. The God of the impossibility. At 90 years, he gave to Sarah laughter, Isaac. Today, may you not be like Sarah, operating the spirit realm with God, all things are possible. I said to those who have faith, all things are possible. Natural world. Kutoka hapa kwenda Embu.
Kuma hapo ni Embu.
Ni pikipiki.
Ni
kutembea.
Ni
baiskeli.
Ni mwindikile.
Ama ni gari.
Kana ni gari.
Kwa sababu hakuna airport katikati ya hapa kutu sina Embu.
Zabu tena airport ya
na kuna ziwa ile tunatumia meli.
Na hotel na hii ya tura kuingia meli.
Hiyo ndio njia yetu ya usafiri. So we already know by time.
Mbona toye?
Kutoka Embu na Kutus.
Kuma ya Kutusi.
Paka Embu.
Yeah.
Hata tukaenda mbio namna gani.
Unaongea utengeretea
tena. Labda dakika 10 hivi.
Noka dakika 10.
Lakini sikia.
Not kirelia.
With God.
Na unaka hivi.
In the spirit realm.
Then you are here kiroho.
Hakuna time.
Kutiko na makida.
Aya. Hakuna time.
Kutiko na makida.
Philip.
Philip.
Siku moja.
Kwenye nyomwe.
Alikuwa kifanya kazi ya huduma.
Antawe ya watu kata.
Akambatiza. The Ethiopian eunuch. What he did not know, from the physical, he will be given a spiritual transportation. When he rose up from the water, he was carried in the spirit. His physical body was carried in the spirit to a place called Azotus, 25 miles. Akipata fahamu anajipata hapo chuka.
Angeipona esuka.
Usishangae, with God all things are possible. Tell your neighbor, with God all things are possible. So at
90,
beyond science, Isaac was born. So shall it be with us. In the name of Jesus. By this force of faith. We shall get what is impossible become a possibility. In the name of Jesus. And let me tell you. That scripture of uprooting the mountain is not only figurative or symbolic, that the difficult things can be uprooted and they become possible. It has also happened in reality. I read a story of this particular family that they were buying land, and where they were allotted the land for their house, there was a hill. And it's these countries that the sun never comes like ours throughout the year. So to have the sun is a miracle. But for them, because of the position of the hill and where the sun is passing, they would not bask the sun in their compound. They had to move to another location where they could enjoy the sun. And they just took the scripture literally that by faith we can uproot mountains. And every morning, the writer of this testimony, he would speak to the mountain. Be thou removed and be cast into the sea. Every morning, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea. 1 month, 1 year. Until this particular day, there came all these big machines.
into the neighborhood. And when he found out what was happening, to his surprise, the government had marked a road to pass through that hill. And what happened? The whole hill was flattened. And he writes, indeed, I have seen a whole hill being cast out because of the speech of faith. May you learn to address your mountains by the force of faith. Speak to them in the name of Jesus. Be uprooted. Be cast into the sea. Even trees. The Bible talks of trees that can be uprooted. Faith is a spiritual force. And it has a name. It is called substance. Hebrews 11:1. The Bible tells us about faith. Okay, if we may get the Hebrews 11:1. Okay, now faith is the substance. Okay, alright. Now faith is the substance. This spiritual force of faith is called substance. That word substance, in another translation, your Bible will translate it to the word reality. No, so to say, now faith is the reality or the assurance. The assurance. What is that now? Uhakika. So imani ni uhakika. Faith is the assurance or even the conviction. And the scripture continues to talk of things hoped for. When you have faith for something, your faith is the substance. In other words, it's the reality of that thing, even if you don't have. Do we get it? Let me give you an example. Let's say you are believing God for this bottle of water. So God has the water. You know the way to receive it is through prayer. And you ask the Father. But you don't ask in unbelief or in doubt. You ask in faith. So the Bible teaches us, anyone who comes to God, first of all, must believe God is. Lazima uamini Mungu yuko. Sasa ukiomba Mungu akupe kitu, naona hakika yuko. So the Bible teaches us, we must believe God is, or the God is there. And he is the reward of those who seek him diligently. So I believe God is. He has the bottle of water. So I ask. And I ask by faith. Let me show you a prayer that is not of faith. Hiyo ni doubt.
Hiyo ni kaja.
Hata shetani atanishtaki.
Ona shetani no achuke.
Atamwambia Mungu.
Ndipira gani?
Ukamuhema hayo.
Usipatie maji.
Ona doe.
Hata hajui.
Kanawe na mo.
Kama uko na maji.
Ona doe.
Hata hajui.
Kana ni umwedete.
Kama unampenda.
Kana ni umuhe.
Kama utampatia.
A prayer of doubt.
Iwe
ya. Never receives anything.
Itia mukagira.
But a prayer of faith.
No, iwe ya.
Comes only.
Kuru oka anda omele.
My Father, in the name of Jesus, you have my water. I am your son. You are my Father. Give it to me now. In Jesus' name. Now,
before it comes into your heart, this is the manifestation. You say amen in faith. When you have faith, God has heard your prayer for water. You are no longer believing. Now you know He is going to give it to you. That's what the Bible says. Faith is the substance of the water hoped for. Are we together? So I am hoping, I am waiting for God to give me water. But when I have faith, I have the assurance. I have the conviction. I have the reality. It is already given to me. So in a car, if you go there, you go there. That is what faith is. Assurance, conviction, reality. In other words, when you have faith, it's just like having the water itself. Faith is reality. Now faith is the reality of things hoped for. So I know that I know I have already received from my Father my water. How are you? Amen. Amen. In a translate from the spirit world into the physical world. Very soon at a point of match. Now, what if one year? You go to Shampatia match. Hey, you are now a mini couple of water. Hey, you are now a mini couple of family. So, the spiritual force of faith will produce results. The spiritual force of faith is what will produce results. Look at your neighbor, tell them, if you want to see results, use the force of faith.
Results, use the
force. Tell somebody else, if you want to see results, use the force of faith. So when you speak, speak by faith. When you pray, prayers of faith. When you declare things, make declarations of faith, you are setting into motion this force of faith into the force of nature. Things will change for you. I told you force, pulls. It pulls or it pushes. By your faith, push away the devil. By your faith, Father Nini, push away the devil. Sasa, huyu ni mtu ako na nguvu kweli kweli.
Uone kwa nguvu na hiyo.
Amesimama.
Aruamete.
Unaweza kafikiri hizi songa.
Na wewe sije kidia.
Ukileta mtu hapa kama Mr. Gari.
Mimi sana kama.
Mimi sina hiyo uwezo. Ukileta hapo Mr. Gari.
Ukileta Mr. Gari.
Apply.
Force.
Ninya. Haya. Mshiri apende asipende.
Mshiri kile kanaje.
Anasonga mbele.
Mungu
jani kiendelee. Amen. Chochote kinachokusumbua leo.
Na
kimetoka kwa ufalme wa giza. Niko hapa kukuambia. Uko na masuala ya imani. Sukuma katika jina la Yesu.
Amen.
Sukuma katika jina la Yesu.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Push by your faith.
Bila kawezekio.
In the name of Jesus.
Bila kawezekio.
Shetani yoyote.
Shetani yoyote.
Na mapepo yoyote. Imani yako. Itawasukuma na kuwaondoa. Katika jina la Yesu.
Ndio
hiyo
alitolea Yesu. Amen. So ukiomba,
ambia kila pepo,
ile ndio iko na yote.
Toka hapa katika jina la Yesu.
Hata ndio alitolea Yesu.
Toka utofia in the name of Jesus.
Hata ndio alitolea Yesu.
You are pushing them by your faith.
Unapa tini
ndio. You are pushing them by your faith.
Basi tini kana wewe kio wako.
Kama wakisonga tu kidogo.
Hadi ndio hadi hivi.
Na bado unawaona.
Ndio hapo.
Endelea kuwasukuma.
Napenda kumatusikia.
Hata waondoke kwa macho yako wasionekane tena. Nishe njia moja ya kusukuma shetani.
Nikikurudia tena moyo wangu tuliko shetani.
Safaricom.
Safaricom.
Iko na kitu inaitwa Airtime.
Niko na kitu inaitwa Airtime.
Airtime?
Airtime.
Pia wako na Airtime.
Unapokuwa na Airtime.
Hiyo inaitwa aje?
Telkom.
Telkom. Pia iko na Airtime.
Niko na Airtime.
Kuna nyingine pia. Oh, ndio hiyo Telkom. Kuna Equitel. Pia wako na?
Niko na Airtime.
Ndio ndio usipatie shetani Airtime. Sime ina hiya tai. Eh,
timu ina hiya
tai. Aishikagi.
Beti taga.
So acha kusema shetani.
Kumbuka shetani.
Shetani. Goma.
Goma.
Waiga. Shetani.
Shetani.
Shetani. You are giving the devil your time. Don't give the devil.
Yeah.
From today.
Mobile.
I want by your faith.
Wewe na Robert kiwa.
To pull.
Mobushie.
And now pull God.
At
the kingdom of God, at the feet of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah! So I'm going to pray to God.
Jesus,
Malaika,
Salma
Mungu. Talk about the kingdom of God. By your words of faith,
you are pulling.
The Bible says, God inhabits the praises of his people. So there are things God is attracted to. And today I tell you, one of it is when we apply the force of faith. In the name of Jesus. You, faith is a spiritual force. It is within you. Learn to release it. When you find a biashara,
wewe utibiadara.
Pull your customers.
Kushia customers yako.
They will come to you.
Na nimeomba kwa wewe.
Amen.
Amen.
Do you need money?
Unapata pesa?
Learn to pull money.
Wewe utakushia pesa.
It will come to you.
Yesu kwa wewe.
By faith.
Na wewe utakia.
Call money.
Itapesa.
Speak to money.
Nenda bia.
Tell money come to me.
Bila pesa
come from the east. Come from the west. Come from the north. Come from the south. Your words of faith will pull finances your way. Angalia vile watu wengine wanafukuzaga biashara.
Rado amore mega tabia.
Oi, umeenda.
Umekauka.
Hakuna biashara.
Pia ndara.
Sasa neno leo juu muno.
Wakati huu ni mbaya.
Hapa hii town ni mbaya sana.
Hiyo
town yenyewe ni mbaya.
Town hiyo tu.
Mtu mwingine mgeni amekuja akainua gorofa kubwa zaidi.
Udoke mwekia wakaka gorofa ndio.
Kuanzia leo hautafukuza baraka zako.
Mungu anaendelea kukushia kuu.
Utakuwa ukiziattract.
Kulipo wakati kuserelia.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Ndio aitwa Yesu.
Oh master. Asa mtuwa kikaka nisa hawelewe.
Umuru wa itaka nikala kikaka.
Pull your husband.
Kushia pull wako.
Kuna mmoja tu mwenye nataka dada kama wewe.
Kuna mmoja wale na
kwa. Ama nataka ndugu kama wewe. Faith.
Wete kiyo.
Is a force.
Nehidia.
On Tuesday.
Mbunyati maile.
Tulikuwa kazi hapa.
Plaza
ndio alikuwa amebaki fundi wa mwisho. Na anarudi Nairobi. So usiku tukienda nyumbani. Tunaenda Embu achukue matatu aende Nairobi. Tumefika kuingia Embu kuna askari. Askari amevaa nguo za EP akatusimamisha. Akatusalimia vizuri sana. Hamjambo? Mumeshindaje? Nikajipata tu nimemwambia. Nimeshinda shetani katika jina la Yesu. Na alikuwa na bunduki. I speak the truth before God. And one if he was here is my witness. Huyo askari alitetemeka. There is a force called faith. So mtu akikuuliza umeshindaje? Kuna vitu tatu umeshinda. Umeshinda shetani. Umeshinda ulimwengu. Na umeshinda mwili wako. Declare your victory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Uhali gani leo? Sisembe nimesota. I am blessed and highly favored. I live a glorious life. I am a son of Abraham. I am a son of God. Hey! Vipi wewe? Ati ni kuhaso, tu ni kuhaso. Let me tell you, you are not a hustler. You are an heir. In the name of Jesus. If you know you are an heir, make a shout of triumph. Watching your force. Amen. Jesus.
Yes.
He has this force in him. Merikebu inapelekwa kushoto na kulia. Wanafunzi au ni fishermen wanajaribu kufanya vile wanajua. Wanajua maji ikijaa kwa merikebu
watasii.
A man of faith. Yeye haogopi. Yeye ni kulala amelala chini ya merikebu. Amelala kabisa. Wanakuja wanapata melala. Master. Don't you care we are perishing? When you have faith, others will be perishing. Wewe utakuwa umetulia tu. It is well with you. Anawaambia nini? Itatanda nini paka lini? And he comes and rebukes the wind. The wind is a force. And it is bringing all these problems. But faith is a greater force. And when he rebukes the wind, it comes down. Even you shall command any storm come in your way and your family and business, and it will stop in the name of Jesus. Our former sister and deputy governor. One time he came to my office here. He told me something. Pastor, kuna maandamano imepangwa kesho hapa Kenyani. Lakini ninajua ni mtu wa Mungu ukiomba. Yote itasambaratika. Nikamwambia piga magoti. Na mimi nikasimama. Kweli deputy governor amepiga magoti. Mimi nimesimama. Nasema in the name of Jesus. Hiyo pepo ya kuleta mtafaruku Kirinyaga. Tumefunga katika jina la Yesu. Hatutakuwa hiyo maandamano. He came back with a testimony. Thanks be to God. Hiyo maandamano haikuendelea. Ukisikia vile kunaenda ama kutakuwa, kumbuka, I have the force of faith. I have the force of faith. Anza kuomba katika jina la Yesu. Anza kufunga katika jina la Yesu. Whatsoever we bind your nerves by the force of faith,
It is bound in heaven. And what we lose here on earth, it is bound in heaven. Amen.
Jesus, by the force of faith, he cast a tree. May nobody ever eat from you. May nobody ever eat
from you.
And left it. And tomorrow, Peter looked at it. Oh, Master, it is already dried. It is the force of faith being released. So shall it be with you. In the name of the Lord Jesus, and give. We'll continue next Wednesday, the next Sunday. Let us all stand up in the name of Jesus. I am here to tell you, you have a spiritual force called faith. Amen. You have a spiritual force called faith. If you see a manifestation of Satan, release your faith in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Release your faith. Release your faith. Do I have men and women of faith here?
Yes.
That are ready to release this spiritual force. Lift up your voice right now in the name of Jesus. And start releasing this force of faith. Speak it right now. Speak your faith right now. Speak it in the name of Jesus. Declare it in the name of Jesus. There is power within you. Release through your word the power of faith, the force of faith, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. By this faith, we stop wheels. By this faith, we cross every tree. By this faith, we uproot every mountain. We uproot every tree. By this faith, we release whatever is bound. By this faith, we bind everything that needs to be bound. In the name of Jesus. Release the force of faith in your body, in your health, in your family, in your business, in your neighborhood. Release this force. Release it right now. Release it right now. Release this faith. Release this force in the name of Jesus. Release it right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus. By this force, pull whatever needs to come your way. Pull everything that needs to come your way. By the force of faith, pull everything that needs to come your way. In the name of Jesus, what was stolen, what went away, what escaped you, pull it right now. In the name of Jesus, pull it right now. There is power released by yourself. Pull it right now. Pull finances your way. Pull divine connections. Pull your customers. Pull them right now. In the name of Jesus. And by the force of faith, push away. Push away everything that should not be near you. Push it right now. Push it right now. Push it in the name of Jesus. Every sickness, arise from my family. Every sickness, arise from this church. Every accident, every calamity, I push you away. By the force of faith, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lift up your right hand and say, thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
You have given me faith.
You have given me faith.
third kind of faith. Today I have understood.
This faith
is a spiritual force.
Therefore I declare right now. By faith,
I push away
everything
that should not be near me. Go ahead and declare them right now. Sickness and disease, go away from me. Poverty, go away from me. Accidents, I push you away. In the name of Jesus, I push you away. In the name of Jesus, you shall not come near me. Terror shall not come near my habitation. Every demonic power, I push you away. You shall not come near me in the name of Jesus. Yes. Hallelujah. Lift up your hand again and say, and now, by this spiritual force,
I pull
towards me.
Every good thing that Jehovah has for me.
Go ahead and pull it right now. I pull finances. I pull divine connection. I pull favor my way. I pull greatness my way. By my spiritual force of faith. In the name of Jesus. Open doors. Greatness. Promotion. I pull it to me. In the name of Jesus. Come to me. Come to me. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. There is faith in this house. Faith is rising up in this house. In the name of Jesus. Let me tell you. In the same lake or sea, where you got nothing, it has many fish. Did you hear what I said? In the same lake where you have toiled the whole night and you got nothing, there are great fish. Now, by the spiritual force of faith, I command all those fish to come your way. I say all those fish will come your way. That's what Jesus did. Told Peter, cast your net on the right side. Jesus samaki. Kokote zilipokuwa. Ziliposikia right side. He was trying to catch fish at night without the force of faith. Now during the day, with the force of faith, the word of faith spoken by Jesus, alipata samaki paka kashanga. Hata na wewe utapata miujiza paka kashanga. I declare to you, by this force of faith, where there was a Red Sea before him, the waters will part. It will become a dry ground. Like Moses, wewe utatembea, upite, wengine wa Misri watazamishwa na hiyo maji yenye ni muujiza wako. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I declare to you, because of this force of faith, like Joshua, your trials of shouting will bring down every wall. For Joshua, it was the wall of Jericho. For you, it shall be a certain wall. It shall collapse. I said it shall collapse. In the name of Jesus. Somebody make a shout of triumph. Hallelujah. 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 There is a force within you called the force of faith.
kuombeombewa. Kila mtu anakuja niombe.
Mungu wote akamwera.
Sokoni sisi mtu ametoka wapi?
Mungu mmoja kwenu mimi nimwera.
Umepakwa mafuta. Umepakwa chumvi. Umepakwa mchanga. Kuanzia leo. The force of faith within him. You shall declare a figure that shall be established in the name of Jesus.
When
you are passed away, because you cannot afford to lack faith. When you are parishioners, they have problems, they call you. Pastor, they obey. Even pastor has problems. He never takes his phone call to call anybody. So by faith, I pray and I say it is done. And I stand in assurance God has heard me. That is where you are coming. In the name of Jesus. Utakuwa wa kuombea wengine sio kuombewa. Shangilia Bwana. Hallelujah. 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 I have men and women of faith in this house. In the name of Jesus. So if you came here, believe in God for a miracle. Nyosha mkono wako imani pokea. Pokea katika jina la Yesu. Chochote unataka kutoka kwa Jehova. Pokea. Katika jina la Yesu. So baada ya kupokea, msikubalie shetani ya kunyang'anya. Ukitoka kwa gate, akuulize. Una hakika? Ati hiyo maji itakuja. Mwambie gate behind me Satan. It is done. It is already given. In the name of the Lord. Or we are not born again. Faith is needed in our salvation. For anybody to be born again, we are born again by faith. We are born again by grace through faith. So faith is needed in our miracle of salvation. You need to believe in your heart. Jesus as Lord and Savior, He died and rose again. Then you confess with your mouth that God raised Him from the dead.